103.2 Preston FM.
Keeping it local.
We've got news of a huge music event that's hopefully coming to Preston in the summer. Details are being drawn up for a large-scale event called Prestival to take place in Avenham Park in September. The aim of the music event is to celebrate today's current music scene, and although organisers are remaining tight-lipped over the exact lineup, there's a promise of recognisable names coming to the city. The idea of the festival is brainchild of Rick Moore from Bamba Bridge. Rick, are you there?
I am. Hi, Simon.
How are you doing? You all right?
I'm good, thanks.
Listen, thanks for joining us today. Yeah, I'm really intrigued about getting some more details about this Prestival, as I'm sure most people around Preston are. So come on, tell me a little bit about Prestival.
Well, what we're looking to do is engage the whole community of Preston in the universal language of music, put together a well-organised, well-received, hopefully, music festival that will incorporate both big name acts and local talent.
Now, I don't suppose you're able to divulge any of the names that you've got in mind for this, are you, Rick?
Unfortunately not. The
Boo
music
hiss.
Industry works a little bit like the Secret Service, and if I told you, they'd have to kill me.
Right. Well, we wouldn't want that because we wouldn't get Prestival. So how did you come up with the idea of this anyway?
All came about because I read an interview with Dave Grohl, who was the drummer with Nirvana and now with Foo Fighters. He criticised in the interview the new generation of musical talent born of shows like The X Factor and The Voice. He was particularly saddened by the fact that kids growing up today tend to relate becoming a successful musician with these shows, manufactured pop acts, rather than, like Nirvana did, going out, buying the instruments, jamming in the garage, and becoming the biggest band in the world.
Yeah, which, I mean, let's face it, we've all, I think, pretty much had enough of the manufactured sort of identikit kind of stars that we've been getting over the last few years. And it has to be said, it seems to be that these talent shows, they don't create longevity.
Definitely not. Or with the likes of, in recent years, Matt Cardle and James Arthur, I think they're thrust into celebrity so quickly that they don't know how to deal with it. And Matt Cardle hit the Priory, James Arthur made some very unfortunate remarks, and they're just not equipped to get there. Coming up through the pubs and clubs gives musicians, I think, an idea of how to respond to the fans. And how to deal with the potential for the wealth that's coming. It's almost like it's drip fed.
Yeah.
But when you just throw it at them, it doesn't seem to do them any good in the long term.
And do you think that's fairly sort of endemic within all of these programs? Is the fact that they're thrown into the limelight, they're doing, you know, huge live shows, they're in front of 10 million people literally within weeks of being discovered. Do you think it's kind of, it's all like, you know, sort of the litmus paper, it's all over too quickly?
I do think so, and I don't think the music industry cares in that sense, because they know that 12 months later there'll be a new person to milk the money from and move on.
Yeah, I mean, that's very sad, and it's a sad indictment to kind of the music scene as it is at the moment, because it does seem literally just kind of here today, gone tomorrow. So what? How will sort of Prestival try and change that?
Well, what we want to do is we want to encourage people to come and see acts that they know and love, and at the same time showcase the local talent. And maybe if we can get a few people into local bars and clubs to see the local talent because of that, then that's going to help. The bigger the audience that these local acts get, the more it helps them to their end goal of becoming successful in the music industry.
Yeah, absolutely. And so in terms of local talent, and we're talking in particular Preston, can you mention anyone that you know you think would be appearing, or any smaller acts that people may have heard of that could be appearing at Prestival?
We've confirmed quite a few. One that immediately springs to mind is James Todd, who's been based in Preston for a number of years now. I'm sure lots of people have heard him.
He's getting quite a name for himself, actually, isn't he?
He has, yeah. He hosts open mic nights at the Adelphi, I think. And, he's a very good act. It would be nice to sort of help him along and get him a wider audience to play to. Mm. But similarly, we've confirmed quite a few local acts on the Facebook page. If people want to go and have a look at that, it's facebook.com/Prestival Preston, and there's a videos section with about 18 to 20 different artists in there, and people can get an idea of the kind of talent that's out there and have a good look. Some of the artists are from a little further afield than Preston, but I think as a city, Preston has a responsibility to pull in the surrounding neighbourhoods. And everybody's from the northwest,
which is excellent because obviously you know we do need to be able to sing the praises of the northwest as much as possible. So tell me, I mean, how far have you got down the line with trying to organise something like this? And how much does this take? How much organisation would something like Prestival take?
It takes a lot of organisation. It's not something that you can put together in a weekend. We've been at it, I would say, from the middle of last summer, probably July. We've had a lot of things to get through, like building and registering the company. There's been a lot of legal stuff to get through. And it's the stuff that you don't see when you go to a festival or even a big music gig. There's so much goes on in the background, and it is very intensive. Mm. We've got four main people working on it and quite a lot of volunteers at the moment, and new offers of voluntary help are coming in all the time, which is fantastic. And it is starting to pull together the community a little bit, and it's been amazing. And that was one of the big aims, so I'm pleased about that.
So go on, talk us through sort of how you actually start to organise something, because you're looking to try and attract around about 20,000 people, is that right?
That's right, yeah.
So how do you start off doing that? Because to be honest, I wouldn't have a Scooby-Doo.
Well, it's basically, it's like building a house, I suppose. You need to put the foundations down first, which is all the production. Obviously, you have to get quotes in, you have to read reviews, find out who's going to be best for the job. We're also looking, from a production point of view, to involve as local businesses as we possibly can. So there's been a lot of research put into that. Once you do that, you have to go through the whole process of proposing the event with the council, drawing up event plans, working through problems that may arise from that, and then there's finding and booking acts, which isn't always as easy as people might think, because obviously artists have other commitments in other areas, even in other countries sometimes, and trying to get a lineup that will be cohesive and appeal right across the board takes a lot of effort, really.
Yeah, absolutely.
But then there's also lots of other little things like merchandising, refreshments, food, all of this has to be planned and worked into the event plan. So, on the whole, it's quite a job.
And how many of you are involved with Prestival at the moment?
Well, Prestival has three directors, myself included, mm-hmm. and one secretary. But we've been lucky and we've had quite a number of volunteers, some from the student union at Preston, at UFAM, mm-hmm. Some through word of mouth and some who are friends. But on the whole, everybody seems to be rallying around and doing their bit.
So, I mean, look, let's nail your colours to the mast. Do we think that this is going to happen? Is the council going to come round to it? Are they going to be supportive? And are we going to have a Prestival at the summer?
I absolutely believe so. If I was going into this half-heartedly, it wouldn't be worth doing. But I absolutely believe that we can make this happen. If we can get the funding in place, which we're working very hard on at the moment, and we've been given some good news by the government, in fact. George Osborne, in his autumn statement...
Sorry, I've just got to stop you there. You've been given good news by George Osborne?
I know,
this
shocking.
Is breaking news, people.
But he's said that anybody investing in social enterprise will receive a 50% tax reduction on that amount invested. So basically that means if somebody were to invest in Prestival, they would only pay half the tax that they would normally pay on that money.
Well, that's great news to start off with, really.
That's a fantastic incentive. Mm. Couple that with the fact that we do find ourselves in a position where anyone investing, we can give a return, and we're looking at giving a 6% return on any investment over a short-term period of something like 3 to 6 months.
Wow, really? You can't guarantee that, surely, though.
Well, obviously, that's based on ticket sales and like buying stocks and shares. Investments can go up as well as down, and terms and conditions apply, blah, blah, blah,
you
blah.
You may lose your house if repayments aren't upheld, yeah.
Exactly. But on the whole, I seriously think that we can do this. We can bring 20,000 people in. There's 26,000 students at UCLAB and Preston College and Newman College. So that in itself is a fantastic base of fans to come and see a well-done event.
Absolutely. Listen, Rick, if people want to get in touch and you've sparked their interest, and if anybody's maybe got any sort of connections to bands or are in fact in a band themselves, what's the best way to get in touch with you?
There's three ways, really. They can come through the Facebook page, which is /Prestival Preston. They can come through the contact page on the website, which is prestival.com. Or they can email us direct at prestival2014@gmail.com.
Fantastic. Okay, well, listen, Rick, thanks for your time today. It's been an absolute pleasure. And I think we'll probably be speaking in the future because this is something that we really want to get behind. And obviously, if there's anything that we here at Preston FM can do, then we'd be more than happy to do that. And if you want to come in, get some bands in or whatever, then I'm more than happy to work that out with you.
I'd love to do that. Thanks very much indeed for your time, Simon.
Listen, no problem. I'll speak to you again soon, mate.
Cheers now.
Cheers, bye.
103.2 Preston FM.
We dare to be different.
Yeah, so if you want to get involved with Prestival, which Rick is organising, then, as you say, you can get onto the Facebook page or you can get him on his Gmail address. But also, if you didn't catch any of those, then get in touch with studio@preston.fm and we'll be sure to forward your details on with